Hello, my name is Madeleine Albright. You may remember me as a former ambassador to the United Nations and as Secretary of State during President Bill Clinton's second term. But today, I greet you simply as a fellow citizen of the United States. Because when I'm asked about the most important event in my life, my answer is becoming an American. Like many of you, I was not born in this country. Instead, I began life in Czechoslovakia, a nation that was taken over first by the Nazis and then by the communists, prompting my family to seek refuge in the United States. I was 11 years old when the ship carrying us steamed around the Statue of Liberty and into New York Harbor. Perhaps you or your loved ones have a similar story to tell. For more than 200 years, our great country has been enriched by the steady flow of immigrants who have contributed to its vitality, prosperity, and democracy. In many respects, our nation's identity is defined by its promise as the land of opportunity. I know that's been true in my case, because where else could a young Czechoslovak refugee have grown up to become Secretary of State? As citizens, we all have a license to dream, and with a passport, we also have the right to travel abroad. One of the first things I did after taking the oath of citizenship was to apply for a passport. Even though I had no immediate plans to go beyond our borders, I thought that having this document was an important part of being an American. So when I was ready to travel, in my case back across the Atlantic to Europe, the passport was my key to exploration and adventure. I encourage you and all American citizens to apply for your ticket to the world, a United States passport. Don't wait. You too can feel that same pride that I experienced when traveling overseas as a citizen of our wonderful nation.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Sarah Taylor. I'm the District Director for the Washington District of U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services, and it's my honor and privilege to be with you here today and to welcome you to this very special naturalization ceremony at the Arlington Central Library, where we are celebrating National Library Week as well as your United States citizenship. Please allow me to introduce to you the dignitaries who have joined me today. You've already met Aaron Cathy, our CISO from the Washington field office. We also have Katie Crystal, Board Chair of Arlington County, and Diane Kresh, Director of Arlington County Public Library. So thank you all for being here. Personally, it's exciting for me to celebrate citizenship during National Library Week. I confess to being a voracious reader, hopefully a good leader too, but a voracious reader, and I love libraries. I feel about libraries the way my son felt about his first Halloween when I sent him out and I said, well, just go knock on their door and say trick or treat. And he came back and he said, Mom, they gave me candy for free. And that's how I feel when I go to a library. They give me a book for free. Anyway, so I love the libraries and I think it's super exciting to be here to celebrate with you. And of course, our libraries aren't just for books anymore, and I'm sure they'll talk about the way they are invested in engaging in the communities and the services that they provide to you. So I'm sure someone will talk to you a little bit about that. So I want to congratulate each and every one of you on reaching this important milestone. Your hard work and determination have led you here, and I'm very pleased and honored to be the one to administer the Oath of Allegiance so that you may very soon become United States citizens. Your spirit and dedication will uphold America's tradition of providing hope and opportunity to generations of immigrants to come. I hope this day inspires you to take full advantage of your United States citizenship and the rights and responsibilities that come along with it. And if in this special day you want to go back and try to remember it, I understand that we are being broadcast on Facebook Live on the Arlington County Library site, or Arlington County website on Facebook. So you can go back and look at that later. So I would like to introduce today, we have our color guard and our vocalist here. So ask everyone to please rise and remain standing for the presentation of colors by the Arlington Joint Public Safety Honor Guard. And please welcome Mayari Loza, a student at Washington Lee High School, who will sing and sign the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
Thank you. Please be seated. Let's have a special round of applause for Mayari in that beautiful rendition of this national anthem. At this time, I would like to invite Aaron Cathy, one of our supervisors at the Washington Field Office, to call the countries and present the candidates for naturalization.
Thank you. Okay, when you hear your country of nationality called, please stand and remain standing. Afghanistan, Albania, Algeria, Bangladesh, Belarus, Bolivia, Brazil. Please remain standing. People's Republic of China, Denmark, Ecuador, Egypt, El Salvador, Ethiopia, France, Germany, Ghana, Guatemala, Honduras, India, Indonesia, Iraq, Italy, Jamaica, Jordan, Madagascar, Mexico, Mongolia, Morocco, Nepal, Nicaragua, Pakistan, Peru, Philippines, Republic of Korea, Russia, Sudan, Sweden, Taiwan, Thailand, Trinidad and Tobago, Turkey, the United Kingdom, Vietnam. If I've not called your country, please, all country, remaining countries not called, please stand at this time. Ms. Taylor, I present to you 55 candidates representing 44 countries who have applied to become citizens of the United States. Each of the candidates has been interviewed by an officer of USCIS, and unless exempted by the law, has demonstrated the ability to read, write, and speak words in the English language. Each has demonstrated his or her knowledge of an understanding of the history and the principles and form of the government of the United States. Ms. Taylor, I recommend that these candidates be administered the oath of allegiance, thereby admitting them to the United States citizenship.
Thank you. Candidates for naturalization, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I hereby declare on oath that I absolutely and entirely renounce and abjure all allegiance and fidelity to any foreign prince, potentate, state or sovereignty, of whom or which I have heretofore been a subject or citizen, that I will support and defend the Constitution and laws of the United States of America against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, that I will bear arms on behalf of the United States when required by the law, that I will perform non-combatant service in the armed forces of the United States when required by the law, that I will perform work of national importance under civilian direction when required by the law, and that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion. So help me God. Congratulations, you're America's newest citizens. As long as I have you standing, we're going to move on to the Pledge of Allegiance. I'd ask our audience to join us as well as members on the stage. When we said the Oath of Allegiance, you stood before me, you raised your right hand, you repeated after me, but you're all citizens now. So when we say the Pledge of Allegiance, we place our right hand over our heart because we love this country. We'll face the flag and we will say the in unison. I would like to invite brand new U.S. citizen Army Specialist Ethan Zimmerman to the stage to please lead the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. You'll notice he was here in uniform. You'll notice he's been serving our country before he was even a citizen, but we have a number of people in that situation who have served our country, have loved our country so much that they've served in our military even before becoming United States citizens. And I'd like to recognize them all, please, by standing. Thank you for your service. Please be seated. I'd like to introduce the Arlington County Chairman, or Chairwoman, person, Katie Crystal. She is a community advocate and public policy professional, and she was elected to the board in November 2015. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Crystal.
Thank you, and good morning. Buenos dias. Assalamu alaikum. There's so many countries represented and so many languages, and it's an honor to share one common nation and one common language this morning. On behalf of all of my colleagues on the Arlington County Board, including Eric Gutschall, we are so proud to be celebrating with you today in Arlington County. It is great to be here for this ceremony, and truly it is an honor to be in your presence today, nearly 55 individuals from 44 different countries, as you take your last step to becoming United States citizens. Thank you to the United States Citizen and Immigration Services for being our partners, for allowing us to host you all today in such a proud moment. And as Sarah noted, if you have loved ones that would like to follow along that cannot be here today, we are live streaming this event on the Arlington County Government Facebook and Twitter pages. You all, no matter whether your journey began decades ago or more recently, have come a long way. Your hard work, your patience has paid off, has been rewarded as you become citizens of the United States today. Believe me when I tell you, it is inspiring to see your commitment to this process. And I can't wait to see what you all do now that you have the opportunity as citizens to engage your voice and engage your opinions with the larger community. We are excited and proud that you have chosen to become United States citizens, and we look forward to your perspectives and ideas as this country moves forward. Congratulations, and thank you.
It is now my honor to introduce you to Diana Kresch. She joined Arlington as the Director of Libraries in April of 2006 after a 31-year career at the Library of Congress. Over the course of her career, Ms. Kresch has earned numerous awards and accolades, including a Top 50 Innovations in American Government Award from the for a Veterans History Project and the Site of the Year Award from Yahoo Internet Life for the September 11th website. So please join me in welcoming Director Diane Kresch.
Good morning, honored guests, Arlington County leaders, and new citizens. It's a privilege for Arlington Public Library to host you and your families on this remarkable day in the middle of National Library Week. Now in its 60th year, when we celebrate libraries and the contributions they've made to our civic and cultural lives. As Katie noted, to be present with us today in this auditorium, many of you embarked on a journey from somewhere else. You left behind families and friends, cities and villages, farms and businesses, good times and bad times, forsaking all that was familiar to begin anew in this great country of ours. On May 23rd, 1914, a fair-haired, blue-eyed, 16-year-old young woman named Jadwiga Apollonia Adamski boarded the SS Kroonland in Antwerp, Belgium. She was alone. She hailed from the town of Jaswini, located in either Poland or Austria, depending upon the geopolitical view of the world. Her occupation was listed as servant. She was a sturdy 4 foot 9 inches tall. She had $25 in her pocket. She was bound for the United States to join her older brother, Gabriel, in Meriden, Connecticut. Gabriel lived at 232 Front Street in Meriden. After a tumultuous 2 weeks at sea, she arrived on these shores on June 2nd. I know these facts because they're collected in libraries and archives, maintained in passenger manifests, census records, newspapers. And as we celebrate National Library Week, we pledge to preserve those facts and the stories they tell, your stories and our stories, stories that become part of the social fabric that unites us and makes us better together than we ever could be alone. Jadwiga soon found work in a corset factory in Meriden, and one day her sewing machine broke. The young man called in to repair her machine was a first-generation Irishman named Walter Nestor, who, according to a faded newspaper clipping, played catcher in a semi-pro baseball league. The machine was fixed, and so too were their fates. Their story became my story. Jadwiga and Walter were my father's parents. Rita Dove, former poet laureate of the Library of Congress, has said, "Libraries are where it all begins." And it's true. Let's think about that for a minute in the context of what it means to be a citizen. Becoming a citizen means being granted certain rights and responsibilities in exchange for active engagement in community life and governance at both the local and the national level. Citizenship is a weighty responsibility, one that requires patience and diligence. Our form of representational government depends on the active engagement of all citizens. And that's where we come in. Libraries, especially public libraries, were founded on the belief that the public has a right to know. And for those of you who like numbers, there are an estimated 16,536 public libraries in the United States just like this one. In fact, there are more libraries in the United States than there are McDonald's. Before he became a founding father, Benjamin Franklin knew well the value of information. Recognizing that books were expensive and beyond the financial reach of most, he and his friends formed the nation's first subscription library, the Library Company of Philadelphia. Founded in 1731 and still in operation today, it was the forerunner of the public library, a collection of books purchased by some for the benefit of all. Steel magnate and industrialist Andrew Carnegie also appreciated the power of information. An immigrant from Scotland who grew up in a one-room weaver's cottage to become at one time the richest man in the world, devoted the latter part of his life to philanthropy. He once said that a library outranks any other one thing a community can do to benefit its people. It is a never-failing spring in the desert. And to prove that he could put his money where his mouth was, between the years 1883 and 1929, Carnegie built more than 2,500 libraries worldwide, and many of them still stand today. Free and unrestricted access to information, the core mission of a library, makes our democracy work by giving all of us the tools we need to pursue the lives we imagine. Libraries are change agents. They collect and preserve books and other materials to challenge our beliefs and biases, to illuminate diverse experiences and cultures, and help us learn to think for ourselves and not follow the crowd or cult of public opinion. Books can charm us, they can disarm us, they can enliven our spirits, and they can cause us despair. They grant equal voice to the ordinary and to the exceptional. They encourage us to ask why and why not. They can please, they can polarize, paper or e, quarto or quartz, on your phone, in your hands. Reading brings knowledge, and with it, the power to inspire, inflame, evoke, and enrich. The theme of this year's National Library Week is Libraries Lead, and today is Take Action for Libraries. As you leave here, we encourage each of you to take action, to become active supporters and users of your local public library. Sign up for a library card, borrow the latest bestseller, drop in on a story time with your children, take a class through an online university, join a conversation group, get instruction on a device, help with finding a job, or simply read a book in companionable silence in a warm and welcoming place. As you nurture your minds and your hearts, you will help your communities grow. If you do your part, we pledge to do ours, to create opportunities to increase understanding of our world, of our communities, and of each other, to respect truth and fairness, and to do so with resolve and compassion, to serve you and all of the Jadwiga Apollonia Adamskis with goodwill, humility, and kindness through books and events within our buildings and outside in our neighborhoods. Congratulations to each of you on your signal achievement. From this day forward, you are what countless others who have gone before you are, citizens of the United States of America. Wear this accomplishment with dignity and pride. You have earned it. Thank you.
Thank you both for those inspiring words, and thank you, Diana, for sharing the story of your own family. I'm sure many of you, as I was, were touched to hear that story, and I encourage you all here to share your stories so that others can know of your journey as well. At this time, we have a special message from the President of the United States, followed by a short musical video.
My dear fellow American, it is with great pride that I welcome you into the American family. No matter where you come from or what faith you practice, this country is now your country. Our history is now your history, and our traditions are now your traditions. You enjoy the full rights and the sacred duties that come with American citizenship. Very, very special. There is no higher honor. There is no greater responsibility. You now share the obligation to teach our values to others, to help newcomers assimilate to our way of life, and uplift America by living according to its highest ideals of self-governance and its highest standards. All Americans are your brothers and sisters, and each of us must do our part to keep America safe, strong, and free. America is our home. We have no other. You have pledged allegiance to America, and when you give your love and loyalty to America, she returns her love and loyalty to you. We share one American heart and one American destiny. It is a destiny filled with love, opportunity, and hope. We celebrate this day. We welcome you into our national family. We applaud your devotion to America, and we embrace the wonderful future we will have together. Thank you, God bless you, and God bless America.
How about that? Are you proud to be an American? Yes, all right. Well, you'll be even more proud when you have your certificates, and that's what we're gonna do next. So I'm gonna ask Aaron to come to the podium. He's gonna call you by name to get your naturalization certificates, and we're gonna I'm gonna have you stand over there. We might have you stand over there. So that people come across and get your certificates, and then you'll hop off and go back to your seats.
start? All right. Oprah Olivia Myers. Vu Duc Tran. Ethan Fernandez Vieira. No need to shake my hands. My hands are full, so. All right. Wegalia Asadi. Haik Coimbra de Oliveira. Ethan Pitawat Zimmerman. Michael Anthony Marshall. Nicoletta Pinzo Lizanti. Inna Anatolievna Ozianikova. Gol Meskioglu Gur. Esma Haram. Saida Ayub. Andrea Michelle Nam. Frederick Siegfried Jacques Ulmer. Najla Nader. Yasmin Christina Rojas Chicas. B. Katrina Malari Rodriguez. Jerry Dawood Alneman. Pavlina Como. Laith Mahdi Motab. Maria Antonia Sarufo. Louise Suzanne Oliver. Dal T. Bikvo. Danny Alma Valdez. Anna Viktorovna Briggs. Ramet Mukhtar Abdusalam. Fatima Diwani. Harlan Maria Medrano. Mesa Mohammed Ahmed Orsud Hamd. Maria Luisa Garcia Arazo. Anya Rosa Lisa Wells. Brooke Wilson. Okay. Alem Legacy Ailo. Ian Bruce Girard. Gina Farinas. Ashraf Mahmoud Ratab Al-Shahabi. Muhammad Ahmed Mawad Muhammad. Yewe Zhu. Rita Anand. Mijung Opark. Oscar Armando Hernandez Reyes. Lillian Saravina Lasut. Marie Claudette Natalie Ravier Ramananan. Roshan Ara. Rina Sharma. Idgelma Alton Gurel. Goretti Pilar Aragon. Lakshmi Narayana Bhuvanagiri. Laura Mariel Huertas Cajas. Laura Castro Cavalcante Levine. Elizabeth Horowitz. Magomed Gajev. Antonio Sogo.
All right, let's have a round of applause for America's newest citizen. It was indeed a privilege for us to be able to be here. I want to thank the Arlington Library for hosting us today and for Director Kresh and Chair Crystal for being here with us today to celebrate your United States citizenship. As your first act of as a U.S. citizen, you got to say the Pledge of Allegiance. Now you have your naturalization certificate. You can walk out that door and register to vote. How about that? Thank you, everyone, for being here. That ends today's ceremony.
Is that good? Washington.